name is Scott, and this is my wife, Christy. Please bear with me, as this is the first Patreon introduction video I have ever made. As a creator, I thought long and hard about how I would put this video together. And I thought to myself, well, Patreon is a creator's funding website, so why not show some of your past creations? The next question I came up with is, what creations am I going to show? Well, here's what I came up with. This is where I went to high school in Kelseyville, California. In high school, I was noticed for creating haunted houses and was presented with Student of the Month for creating the first haunted house ever at the high school. I was also awarded Most Talented Senior and Senior Musician. Music is another thing I've always been passionate about, and I've played drums since I was about 13 years old. I've played many different types of bands and many different events since those days. Drumming is one of those creative endeavors that I started early in life. Drumming is definitely one of the most challenging skills I've tried to learn in my lifetime. One thing I've learned playing the drums, it's going to take a lot of effort to get it right. Christy and I would end up meeting and putting together a very unique karaoke show. Christy was an awesome karaoke singer who I met while I was doing a gig out at the coast. She has her own creative endeavors, which include floral design and hand painting awesome garden signs. With everything else we do, Christy and I decided to put together our own DJ and karaoke company. The idea for me to create a DJ company that featured video and karaoke came to me years and years ago, even before karaoke was a big deal. The idea back then was to be called K-Video, and it was to feature video and music. It later became Future Star Karaoke. Our initial Future Star shows started out in Ilwaco, Washington. Christy and I started Future Star Karaoke out on the Oregon coast, and it quickly migrated to Las Vegas, where it became very popular. We ended up working for Las Vegas Entertainment Productions, where we soon ended up working for some of the largest casinos in Las Vegas. We would eventually find ourselves working on Fremont Street, running our own show called Monster Talent Show. And even to this day, as we travel, we run Future Star Karaoke events around the country. Along with my passion for drumming and music, I love bicycles, and in this case, I combine both of them. I call this creation the drum cycle. This one's called the steamer bike. And this one here is called the corpse cycle. Another thing I'd like to mention is Spas Out, which is a precursor to Inspector Spa. A long time ago, I put together this business where I designed, fabricated, and repaired hot tubs. As in the case with most all of my creations, everything starts with a drawing. One of my biggest creative endeavors was probably skateboarding back in the 70s. In those days, skate parks weren't invented yet, so we had to make our own. And we made them out of whatever scrap wood we could find. I even managed to get in a movie and end up in a couple skateboarder magazines. That passion still continues today, and you might catch me riding a skateboard at 54 years old. This gentleman is named Jim Bishop, and he had built a castle. And he inspired me to build a castle, which I did. It was then featured on the Learning Channel and in various newspapers. Unlike the stone castle Jim Bishop had built for his son, my castle was made all out of driftwood. One thing is for sure, and that is this castle would have never been built if it wasn't for the inspiration of Jim Bishop. What you're looking at right now is another castle, although this is a Gothic castle themed hotel room that I did. I had to throw it in because it's a Gothic themed hotel room. And I don't care who you are, that's just cool. One of my daily creative endeavors is creating videos for YouTube. I'm not a professional, but I have won awards for my videos. I've also had them featured at very famous theaters in Hollywood. And just like my other creations, it all starts with a drawing. I built my first haunted house back in the 80s in the basement of my mom's ranch house. And then when I got a bit older and had kids of my own, I built a haunted house down in the basement of my own house in Salem, Oregon. My passion would end up growing and I would build the Wizard's Dungeon the following year. We opened up my home haunt to the kids of the neighborhood and it was a smash hit. Soon the idea of building my first professional haunted house called Hotel Hysteria was born. I would soon start designing and building all the props I would need for the attraction After Hours in the shop at my work. This is where I first learned how to create my own animatronics. And this is where I put together my first plan and proposal for the Lost Bunker of Terror professional haunted house. I developed this plan to be part of the Ilwaco, Washington Coast Guard Halloween event. This event was never realized, but it did motivate me to move on to bigger venues. And when I'm talking about a bigger venue, I'm talking about world record size. Before I could attempt to create a world record Halloween event, I had to start a little bit smaller. So we started here, at a place here in Las Vegas called Mahoney's Silver Nugget Casino, which is incidentally where we got our first DJ and karaoke show in Las Vegas. I produced these sets for a casino high roller event. This would lead me to setting up my first professional haunt at the casino called Hysteria City, which in turn would lead me to building many, many other haunted attractions for many years afterwards. And some of those events were quite successful and others not so much. But the fact is, we ran those big giant Halloween events for 13 years, and in 2007 we even attempted a world record. This event was called Monster Mayhem and was right on the Las Vegas Strip. This was by far the most successful event I had ever put on. That event would then lead to creating Zombie Precinct at New York Casino in Las Vegas. It was not only awesome to see my dream being realized with my haunted house right here at New York Casino, but it was also cool to see my artwork plastered all over the giant marquees here on the Las Vegas Strip. I've also been blessed to put on events like Bonnie Screams Ghost Town and so many more. I knew I'd been doing something right when Kimberly J. Brown of the Disney Channel showed up at my event. And through all of these haunted houses, I even put together my own little book I call the Haunt Bible. And what I'm trying to show you through all of these past creations that I've accomplished is that I am truly a creator at heart, and I definitely usually always have a plan when I go into a project. And right now, one of my biggest projects is trying to create quality YouTube videos that are both entertaining and somewhat educational. The videos I usually create are based off of my RV travels. And my goal is to create 3 quality videos each and every week. To make these videos possible and to make travel possible in my RV, I use all of the creative endeavors that I've showed you so far in this video. And just to reiterate, the creative methods I use to make my journey possible are graphic design, mural and window painting, creating professional props and scenery, hot tub manufacture and repair, future star karaoke and DJ, and now my attempt at a YouTube income. The biggest problem I've found so far with doing all of these things in a mobile lifestyle is having a place to put everything you need to do what you do. And speaking of things I need to do, did I mention I paint holiday windows? Yep, I've been painting holiday windows since 1983, and here's a picture of me way back then. And here's the first card I made for painting windows way back then. I have definitely painted a lot of fun windows for a lot of fun people for any reason or any season. And Christmas is right around the corner, so I'll be out there making an attempt to make everybody's Christmas just a little bit brighter. So even the window painting and mural painting takes up more room in the RV. And that's why I'm doing Patreon, because Christy and I are trying to update our RV into a bus. In case you don't know, one of my passions in life is creating or restoring RVs into custom one-of-a-kind works of art. And what you're looking at right now is a 1959 Crown Coach that a buddy of mine and myself turned into a motorhome. Yep, the old yellow school bus was my first encounter with creating a motorhome from scratch. Since then, I've remodeled several different RVs, including the one I'm in right now. And that brings me to my main goal on Patreon. Christy and I are trying to get the funds together to build a bus that is suitable for us and our lifestyle and all of the equipment it takes for us to do what we have to do while we're on the road. We're not looking for you to help buy the bus, we're looking for you to help sponsor the bus. We're building a sponsorship program that will offer some awesome perks to our Patreon supporters. We'll have a whole list of Patreon sponsorship perks in an upcoming video. But no matter what, I'll still be trying to put out 3 videos a week so you guys can see what we're up to. Thank you guys for watching this video, and remember, I've got more coming from the RV bandwagon right about now. Thanks for watching. You have made our day. Check out our previous videos. We have a ton of videos for you to see. Please share and give us a thumbs up if you like this video. Please subscribe because the best is yet to come. And remember, have a nice day because you deserve it.